Look at all this amazing art. Man, I really wish I was able to draw.
You are, you stupid f***. You just need to start practicing it.
What? No, I can't.
Oh, really? Have you ever even tried to draw? You haven't, eh?
I tried once like 2 years ago and it didn't work out. It just looked ugly.
Dude, you spent like 2 minutes and zero effort on that. Like, what did you expect?
I don't know.
If you want to get good at drawing, you gotta start practicing it.
Fine. I'll watch the tutorial.
Good.
See, I can't draw it. It just looks ugly.
Dude, it'll take more time than that to get good, you know?
What? Are you telling me it actually takes effort to be able to draw? That can't be right. All right. I'll try harder. Just shut your mouth. In this beautiful fandom, there are tons of amazing artists drawing a ton of super cool fluffy animals. So one day I was wondering if I could do the same thing. I quickly found an answer to it, and it's yes. Yes, I can draw super cute fluffy animals. I just need a lot more practice before I'll be able to do it. You see, I found a rule. It's called the 10,000 hours rule. It says that to reach the top of a field, like really the top, it will take me at least 10,000 hours of practice to get there. That's a pretty terrifying number. That's the same as practicing for 1 hour every day for 27 years and 265 days. But I mean, it's also pretty cool though, right? Because it means that I can become anything I want as long as I get all of them hours of practice down. Wanna become an amazingly skilled artist? 10,000 hours, done. Wanna become an amazingly skilled brain surgeon? 10,000 hours, done. But then again, it's pretty depressing. It's 10,000 hours, you know? I wanna be able to draw super cool fluffy animals right now, not 10 to 30 years into the future. However, I did some more digging, and I found a way more motivating rule. It says that with about 20 to 30 hours of deliberate practice, I will gain the basic understanding of something. So, that means that if I spend 30 hours on trying to draw furries, I should be able to draw furries that looks okay-ish. So, with all of that in mind, I decided that I was gonna draw for 1 hour a day, 30 days in a row. I started by looking up tutorials on how to draw, which led me to draw with Jessa's YouTube channel. There I found something insanely cool, which I will recreate right now. Here we have a small stick figure, however this is a very, very bad stick figure. Now if we just do some small changes, it's already kinda looking better, it looks more human-like. If we then start moving the limbs around, we show the stick figure trying to communicate something. And if we then add in slightly more movement, we can make things look pretty cool actually. We can even start making animations by just using simple stick figures. Another cool thing that Jessa taught me is that everything we draw is built up by really simple shapes. Take the human body for example. The breast is just a big rectangle, the shoulders are just small circles, the head is just another circle, and that's pretty much how things go. We draw the simple shapes and then we start building on top of those shapes. So thanks for all that lovely information, Jessa. You are really inspiring and I love your content. After I had gotten some basic drawing knowledge, I started looking up pictures and tutorials on foxes, because you know, I'm a filthy furry, I wanna draw foxes. And here you see some of the stuff I drew in the first couple of days. It's pretty bad. And I had actually been trying to draw for like a year and a half before I did the challenge. It's just that for that year and a half I didn't really try very hard. Yeah. After some days of trying my best to draw foxes, I quickly found out that trying to draw when I don't really know how to feels really bad. It felt like everything I drew looked like it could have been made by a kindergartner, and it honestly probably could have been. It doesn't feel good knowing that I absolutely suck. But I figured I'd just continue drawing, even if it felt awful, because, you know, I had set a goal. I wanted to be able to draw furries, and I will be able to. I just gotta keep on trying. So, day 15. On a lot of days, I was feeling like I wasn't making any progress at all. Sometimes it felt like I did even worse than I did at the beginning. So, that kinda sucked. But even on those days though, it was still pretty cool and comforting to be able to see the lines on the paper in front of me. Sure, the lines were absolutely awful, but they were there. I had been sitting and drawing for an hour. I had done something. And I also started feeling more comfortable with drawing. Sure, the drawing still looked like a miscarriage, but I started feeling more comfortable with being bad at it. I accepted that I was awful, and it's okay to be awful. Just have fun with drawing. That's what's important. So figuring that out was pretty cool. Fast forward to day 30. Now I had been drawing for an hour a day for an entire month, and I'd actually continued to draw for a couple of days after that as well. It still doesn't look very good, but it certainly got way better than what it was. There are still tons of things missing, and I still have a really long way to go if I ever want to get really good. But you know, it's a start, and it feels nice to have a start. As a whole, I really love doing this challenge. It's a very cool way to try to learn something, and it can be applied to pretty much anything. Take Boy in a Band for example. 30 days of trying to sing, boom, he got better at singing. Amazing. So if there's anything that you want to learn, like dancing or first making, or you know, whatever, maybe you can try this out as well. It's both very fun and also very challenging at times. So that was everything I had to say. Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great day, you lovely creature. Bye bye. Ah, feels so good. 30 days in a row, man.
Yeah, I'll admit, you did a pretty good job.
Thanks, I feel really proud, you know? I'm satisfied.
Yeah, it was a rad start. Now you just need to continue, you know?
Yeah, I'm just... Yeah. Yeah.
So, are you gonna continue? Dude, you can't stop now. You were on such a good roll.
Don't worry, I'm continuing. I just need a little break.
A little break? All right. How long are we talking?
Oh, just 3-4 months or something, and then I'll get right back to it, I promise.
Oh, for sake.
If you like this video, it would be really helpful if you shared it, as it, you know, it helps get the word out and stuff. As always, my character is drawn by Luxus Stargriff, and the background music is created by Laugh at the Fox. Please check them both out, they are really amazing people. That was all, folks. Bye-bye.